my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss an important function of chloroplast, that is the photosynthesis. Okay, let us start with the photosynthesis. Initially, see what is the photosynthesis. Photo means light. Synthesis means preparation. Actually, the photosynthesis can occur in the green plants because the green plants that utilizing light energy and prepared their own food. That is the glucose. Simply, the preparation of glucose by utilizing the light energy, which is called as a photosynthesis. Let us see the equation. Actually, see 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives rise to the glucose, that is C6H12O6 plus it releases the 6 oxygen moieties to the air. So, it is a glucose. This is the equation. What happening by utilizing 6CO2 and 6H2O, it producing the glucose and releasing the oxygen in the presence of light energy. Light energy with the usage of chlorophyll. This is most important equation regarding to the photosynthesis. If you understand this equation, we will see where actually carbon 6CO2 is utilizing and water is utilizing and how it producing glucose and which place and where actually this glucose is producing and where actually this oxygen is releasing into outside of the environment. Okay, let us start with the actually this photosynthesis that occurred in the plants, higher plants, in the thylakoids. In previous class, I already told where actually thylakoids are present. Okay, whereas some prokaryotes like green sulfur bacteria, these photosynthesis can occur in the plasma membrane. Okay, coming to the another bacteria, that is a purple sulfur bacteria. These photosynthesis can occur in the chromatophores. Chromatophores are the invaginations of the plasma membrane. Is it right? This is very important for the comparison of photosynthesis place. Okay. Now, coming to the plants and thylakoids. We know very well actually the chloroplast that contains the cyclic structures, they called individual sac, it is called as a thylakoid. In this thylakoid, the complete photosynthesis can occur. Okay, actually see, this is the thylakoid and the empty place of chloroplast. This is the chloroplast. This part is the thylakoid, empty space here we are seeing is a stroma. Okay. So, now coming to the photosynthesis. The photosynthesis can broadly divide into two categories. One is a light reaction. Second one is the dark reaction. Dark reaction. The light reaction can occur in the presence of light, whereas dark reaction can occur in the absence of light. Okay. Now see, the light reaction that occurred in the thylakoids, whereas dark reaction that occurred in the stroma of chloroplast. Here the thylakoids that contains the chlorophyll, the thylakoids that contains the chlorophyll, here actually chlorophylls are present. Okay, whereas the stroma that is consist of many enzymes are essential enzymes. Okay, now let us see actually how these thylakoids and stroma, which are essential for the synthesis of glucose, that is our target. Let us start with the a diagram showing these thylakoid. Okay. See, actually thylakoid, I am drawing thylakoid. This thylakoid I am enlarging here, a single thylakoid. This thylakoid, that is a double membrane structure. Like this. Actually, the thylakoid that contains the light reaction, that is essential for the light reaction. Again, this light reaction can done by the two photosynthetically active substances. Those include photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Actually, these photosystem 1, 2 we called as the reaction centers. Reaction centers. That means the reaction centers are combinations of proteins along with the chlorophyll. Along with the chlorophyll. So, these reaction centers, which are essential for the synthesis of glucose. So, let us see, actually these photosystem 2 and photosystem 1, which are present in the thylakoid membrane. Thylakoid membrane. This is the membrane. This empty space we call as a thylakoid lumen. The outer side we call as a matrix. Sorry, stroma. You just assume like this. This is a chloroplast. You just assume this chloroplast that contains stroma and lumen of thylakoid and thylakoid. I am showing only one thylakoid here. Actually, see the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Basically, the photosystem 2 absorbs light energy at the wavelength of 680 nanometer. 680 nanometer. Whereas photosystem 1, which absorbs the light energy at the wavelength of 700 nanometer. That's why the photosystem 1 we called as a P700. The photosystem 2 we called as a P680. Now let us say, actually here the photosystem 2 is present. What happening? Basically the photosystem 2, that is a P680. Initially that absorbs the light energy. Initially that absorbs the light energy. Is the light. Absorb the light energy These due to the action of light on the P680, these P680 get excited and this converts water H2O into the oxygen plus 4H plus ions, and also it taken 4 electrons. What happening when light attack to the P680, then that converts H2O water into the oxygen and 4 protons, and also 4 electrons, that is absorbed P680 and get excited. Now this excited condition that releases these electrons to the one more protein that is called as a cytochrome B6F complex. Then from P680 the electrons are received by the cytochrome B6F complex. Again, which transfer these 4 electrons to the one more complex, along with the it transport 4 protons into the lumen of thylakoid. Now let us see which transport the electrons to the one more complex, that is called as a photosystem 1 P700. From where actually these electron transfer to the one more protein complex, that is called as a pyridoxin NADPH reductase. This is also a part of thylakoid membrane. What happening, see, from electrons from H2O to the P68, and from where to the cytochrome B6F, from where to the P700, from where to the flavoprotein pyridoxin NADPH reductase. Is it right? Now let us see this NADPH reductase that converts NADP plus inorganic phosphate into the NADPH. Actually, this NADPH that released into the stroma of chloroplast, that is a very, very important. Whereas, see, the oxygen which are released into the lumen of thylakoid. Again, these protons which are present in the lumen of thylakoids, and these protons also which are present in the lumen of thylakoid, these two protons which forms the proton gradient. This proton gradient, which is utilized by a protein complex called as ATPase, the ATPase which utilizes this proton gradient and that convert ATP plus inorganic phosphate into the ATP. Now see what happened. The ATP is which is released into the stroma of chloroplast. NADPH also released into the stroma of chloroplast. Now these two substances, the ATP and NADP, these two substances are utilized by a complex mechanism or complex cycle that is called as a Kelvin cycle. Actually this stroma that contains the RuBP, that means ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, that is converted into the 3-phosphoglycerate. By the enzyme we called as a Rubisco. Here the RuBP that convert into 3-phosphoglycerate by addition of carbon dioxide. This is very very important. By addition of carbon dioxide. Here what happened? The carbon dioxide that is taken by the RuBP by the enzyme Rubisco that converted into the 3-phosphoglycerate. Again, these 3-phosphoglycerate that converted into the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Again, these 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate that converted into the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Again, these glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that converted into the RuBP. Entire this cycle we call as a Kelvin cycle. Kelvin cycle. Here, see, formed glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that enter into the cytoplasm. Now, let us say, actually, this is the chloroplast. That chloroplast that contains the thylakoid. In the thylakoid, the light reaction can occur by the P680 and P700. Whereas after that, these released NADPH and also ATP that enter into the stroma of chloroplast. These stroma that is site for the Kelvin cycle. Here, the Kelvin cycle we called as the formation of Kelvin cycle, the appearance of Kelvin cycle we called as dark reaction. This reaction actually occur when light is absent. The dark reaction is the formation of Kelvin cycle by the results of the light reaction. Now let us see what happened. The formed glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that enter into the cytoplasm. Let us see here. This is a cell. The cell that contains the chloroplast here. That chloroplast released glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Is it right? The glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that finally converted into the glucose. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that finally converted into the glucose. That is simply called as gluconeogenesis. Okay. This is all about the reactions which are involved in the photosynthesis. Let us check the reactions what we are writing here in the box and what we are drawing in the diagram. Okay. See, the 6CO2, where actually 6CO2 is utilizing, the 6CO2 is utilizing in the dark reaction in the stroma of chloroplast. Coming to the 6H2O, the 6H2O which is utilized in the lumen of thylakoid, where that convert into the oxygen and protons. Now see, here is a light energy. Light energy that is utilized by the P680 nanometer, P680 complex and P700 complex. These P700 complex, P680 complex are reaction centers that contains the chlorophyll. Here is the chlorophyll. Now what it produces? It producing finally glucose. The final glucose end product is here. The glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate that enter into the cytoplasm where actually glucose is formed. Okay, coming to the 6O2. 6O2 is releasing in the lumen of thylakoid. So we all the components which what we are writing here, that all are present here. This is all about the photosynthesis. Here some point to be noted. Let us see the ATPs. The ATPs which are present in the thylakoid membrane. The ATPs which are present in the mitochondrial inner membrane. ATPase. The ATPase that are present in the mitochondrial inner membrane, the ATPase that are present in the thylakoid membrane are same. But their pose is very pose. Pose means, for example, see. This is a mitochondria inner membrane. And here is a thylakoid inner membrane. Thylakoid inner membrane. In the mitochondria inner membrane, the ATPase that exposed into the lumen of mitochondria. But in the thylakoid region, the ATPase that is exposed into the stroma of chloroplast. Means this bubble like structure we called as a F1. Here is the F1, this is the F0, this is the F0. Is it right? The F0 region and F1 region that is exposed inside of the mitochondria inner membrane. Here, the F1 region that exposed outside of the thylakoid membrane. This is a very, very important, it is to be noted. Okay. So, in this way, complete photosynthesis can occur. Here one more important point to be noted. Actually, the TCS cycle, most of the people are confusing with this. The TCS cycle, which is occurred in the aerobic respiration through the mitochondria. Whereas the Kelvin cycle, that is occurring in the photosynthesis through the chloroplast. This is two or the important, many times they will ask this question. The TCA cycle is occurring in which of the following organelle? Whereas the Kelvin cycle is occurring in which of the following organelle? So these are the two important questions. One is the pose of ATPase. Second one is the TCA cycle and Kelvin cycle. So in this way, the higher plants that performing the photosynthesis reaction. So I hope it is a very clear to understand. So if you really understood this concept and if you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel, like, share and comment. Thank you.